get the you get that content, you know. If they constantly keep with the content, you get it's almost like DLC for regular games. You know, you spend $60 on a regular game, then its DLC comes out, and you spend like 15 or 20 bucks on that. You know, you get this little 2-hour thing of content. But with with an MMO, like every month, you know, they come out with like one big patch, or every month they come out with several small patches, but they bring in so much content that you may not see it at first, but you're going to eventually get to it. And it justifies that
$15. Like Titanfall just came out, and there's already DLC for it. I mean, it just feels, you feel cheated.
There is.
You do. You really are going to cheat a lot of these.
Shows their DLC they're offering.
For Titanfall?
What the fuck?
Well, it's not out yet. It's coming out here in a month and a half.
No, they want
months.
You to buy the season pass.
Well, think about Castlevania: Lords of Shadow 2. It came out this month, the beginning of March, and on the 25th, they're already going to have DLC out for it.
Well, yeah that's how they encourage pre-orders. They encourage you.
Like
they do that because they encourage you to do pre-orders so you get exclusive content, exclusive things like that.
There is no.
And then they hold off
pre-order.
Parts of the game to get you to buy it later.
Yeah. What they'll always say, and I'm sure in some instances this is the case, is that like those parts of the game aren't fully polished yet, and they have to ship the game at this date.
Right,
so like,
because of publishers.
We'll just release it in a month or so when we actually have it ready for the public to play as a DLC. I'm sure that happens sometimes. Other times, right, and other times they'll probably just hold the content back, saying, "Well, you know, we can just." I'm sure fucking Call of Duty does that shit all the damn time. Like,
oh yeah, Call of Duty's got it all bad.
They're just maps.
Yeah.
They're just pictures. I don't see why that's such a big fucking $50 deal.
Sake,
it's like Battlefield 4.
How many hours I spent in the Counter-Strike Source map editor? You just like fucking make maps. Like it's not hard.
No,
it's just time consuming.
Look at Portal 2 and the community editor.
Oh yeah.
Al does it right for sure.
Yeah.
And that's what the consoles have got to start doing. They've got to start allowing things for like that. That was a big talk about allowing you to do it. Yeah, there was a bunch of rumors and crap like that. They were going to allow it on this coming generation. They were going to try to set it up where you could do these things. And, you know, kind of like on Halo 3, you know, you could build your own maps and stuff. And it was simplified. It was easy. And you could do some... Yeah, but 4 doesn't work near as well as 3 did, I think. I think 4 was really fucked up when it came to the map creator. They need to be able to do that and really push it to where it's like on PC. That's where PC players have the real benefits, all the modding of the games.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, you could take a 5-year-old game and make it look brand freaking new with top of the line. I mean, look at Grand Theft Auto
4.
4.
Those that CS Ice Mod or whatever. Man, that thing made the game look realistic. It was amazing what they did with that mod.
It was sick.
There is even an HD mod for Battlefield 3 on the PC that like increased the resolution like beyond 1080p or whatever.
I heard about that.
Computer in order to do it. My buddy Dave's computer, he was able to run it, and like his computer's ridiculous. He was able to run like 10 instances of it, but I'm like, whatever. I don't know why you need to do that, but that looked amazing. But no, you just can't do that kind of shit on console. And I think like the biggest problem with that is the console will always have a limitation because you can't upgrade the hardware. It will always be that until you know the next system comes out. Or with the PC, they can just be like, all right, you know, if your computer sucks, you can do this. But if you have a fucking like god of a machine, you can do all these other things.
Right.
You know, it's just up to you, like as the user.
That's something I'm surprised I haven't integrated even just a little bit on these new consoles is being able to, you know, change something out to, you know, your graphics card or whatever, just to make it last longer.
Yeah.
Well, I think that's what they're trying to get at with the Steam boxes. Yeah, they'll be way more expensive for nicer ones than one of the consoles, but with that OS and everything.
Like
it is. The new consoles. The new consoles are structured just like a PC now, and so I think that's what they're getting at with the Steam Box. And like, I think the Steam OS is a really awesome idea because it gets rid of all that bullshit that you have in the background running that makes you have to have, you know.
Well, it focuses more power on the computer, being able to process games and things like that, instead of having to focus on, like, Windows, where it says, hey, let's process Windows.
So you could build, you know, a $400, $500 computer, and it'd be really fast for playing games if you use that OS, where you have to install Windows or whatever. I mean, a $500 Windows computer is kind of like,
Resource management. Not even resource management.
I mean, it'd just be like for browsing internet. That's all you're gonna get with that.
Yeah.
I mean, like.
Yeah, you're gonna be able to toss off to your porn. That's about all.
Right.
And there you go. You just buy a netbook for that. Use your iPhone.
Yeah. I mean, that's what they ought to call it. They ought to call it the. You know, you have a gaming machine. You have a porn machine. Then you have your email machine. Really.
That's really what it all is.
You go to Best Buy.
The case for your computers is the big tit.
Suckle the tit and you'll get your porn. And on that note, one thing I wanted to say about the MMOs, though, they should really put The Secret World on consoles or something else. That game should be more played, because that game is awesome. If no one, I know Kenny's played it, but if you guys have not played The Secret World, definitely check that game out. I mean, you had to buy it, and it's usually pretty cheap most of the time, but it's free to play after that. But it's a fantastic MMO. I mean, I'm pretty sure Kenny can contest to that being a great MMO.
Yeah, it's great.
So anyway, thanks everyone for being on here, and hopefully we can do this again. I mean, I'm thinking we should probably do some more of these shows.
Hopefully you get a video.
Yeah, I'll have to get video so that way you can see my handsome face.
Yeah, no doubt. We gotta see that ugly mug.
Yeah.
We should do one outside of just the internet, like.
Well, right. Yeah. I mean, I would like for us to all to get in one room and do one. That would be.
You get in a room.
That would be a lot.
I know. The last time I got in a room with a bunch of guys, it happened.
Yeah.
Get some pizza and some beer.
Yeah. There we go. That sounds like a plan to me. Sounds like a plan to me. All right, guys. Well, thanks for everyone. Thanks everyone for coming and everyone watching. We will all see you next time. Goodbye.
Bye.
All right. Toodles.